Okay, we're going to have a neck, chest and shoulder stretch from the floor. So if you do have a mat or a nice soft floor, this is probably the best place to do it. I did do a video understanding neck, chest, shoulder stretch, which is great if that's all that's available. But if there is floor that's available, then that's even better. So again, just like the standing sequence, a great place to start can be a reverse prayer. So taking the fingers behind the back, try and turn them so they're pointing up the back. Gentle with the shoulders as you wiggle those hands into position. And then inhale, lengthen the spine, draw the palms together. Exhale, draw the elbows and shoulders back, letting that chest and shoulders open up. Okay, then we'll go straight into the best ones on the floor here, which is a pec major stretch. So that's chest opener on the floor like this, taking my left shoulder at left elbow at shoulder height and 90 degrees. If you want to start with the head down, that's fine. Or if you need it to be up, that's fine too. And here I'm using my right hand to elevate the right shoulder just slightly as I inhale and then exhale and turn that left shoulder into the floor. So inhale, lift the right shoulder, exhale, turn the left shoulder into the floor. Just sinking deeper into that stretch using the breathing. Okay, so depending on how long you need that one, that can be 10 to 15 breaths. And then to come out of there, just let the pressure off the shoulders. And a good one to follow this up with is just to go straight into a straight arm version of this one, which gets through your upper chest or your pec minor and even your rotator cuff muscles. This can even give you a little bit of a nerve stretch up through the shoulder here. So if you're doing this one, you'd be a little more careful. Still inhale and lift the right shoulder. Exhale and gently turn that left shoulder down. Gently down. Okay, so to swap that over, just flip the knees over to the other side. Both knees are together, over to the side. Here we've got right elbow at shoulder height and 90 degrees. Inhaling, lifting the left shoulder. Exhaling, turning that right shoulder down. And good, coming back to the middle. Then we can go straight arm. Again, less pressure when you're doing the straight arm position here. We're getting into some smaller muscles. And good. Gently up. And then a great place to do the rest of your neck and shoulder stretches is from your knees. You can stretch through your ankles and knees whilst you're here. So next one, we're going to do an upper hand grab where we try and take the left hand behind the back, reach over the shoulder and join the fingers together like this. So left hand behind the back and right hand over. And the disclaimer is here, I can't actually do that. I'll show you how close I get. But my shoulders are pretty strong and tight. So even if you can't quite reach, you can still get a good stretch out of this one. Just inhale, try and reach down the back with that upper hand. Exhale, try and draw that lower elbow and shoulder back slightly to open up that chest and shoulder. And gently down, so swapping over. Now right hand coming up the back, left hand coming over. You're going to try and join those fingers together. Okay, if they can't reach, doesn't matter. If they can reach, even better, you can use those hands to hold you in a nice deep stretch. And still inhale, elevate that upper elbow. Exhale, draw that lower elbow gently back just to let that shoulder stretch. And good, gently down. And then we can end that little sequence with a reverse prayer again. So take those fingers together behind the back. Coming up to the end of a 5-minute sequence, which anyone can make 5 minutes. If you're in pain or you're not functioning well, you could do this little sequence once or twice a day and I'll bet it would help you a lot. Stretching is individual, so you should focus on your tight spots, but you might find out where they are with just a few little movements like this. Thanks and bye.